these T-Birds just happen to be watchers of my shh. My name is Jimmy Pynk, and I'm having all kind of issues. So this is what we gonna do. We gonna review the first half of episode one. There are so many looks. I have so much to do. There are so many notes to take. I'm not even gonna tell y'all about my nails that I just put on that broke. Sheen fell for these nails. These is the worst ones I ever had. But I wanna go over the looks of episode one. We've already done the entrance looks. So we're gonna go, if we have to do the entrance looks, that's four looks in one episode. So we will do the first challenge of episode one, which is the old fame, new fame runways. Okay. A couple other things I want to tell you guys. Hey, to my new $20 patron, thank you. I sent you an email. I need a size to send your t-shirt out. And yes, because if you become a $20 patron, you get a t-shirt. Also, shout out to Jay Mikael and Sierra Cyrus, Luminara 843, because they gave you girls something for a birthday. And if you want to see my birthday outfit, well, here go. All right, y'all know what it is. Birthday outfit time, Pynk O' DeMille. Your girl always wear pink on her birthday. So let me show y'all a couple things I got. This is a cute little skirt from Dolls Kill. We got the matching velour zip-up jacket over here. We keeping it real 90s. Keeping it real 90s. Keeping it real nostalgia mask. Y'all know about them velour zip-up jogging suits. That's old school. Then we go on over to the sheen portion. We got the pink socks with the Powerpuff Girls on it. You know how I get down. Just in case, because, you know, it's Pynk O' DeMille, and the margaritas might be flowing, so we got the little shorts to go underneath the skirt. Also, Powerpuff Girls, those are Sheen. We got these little hair clips from Sheen, too. I don't know where they're going to go in my hair, but they're just, like, on bobby pins, and you can see this Blossom, Bubbles, Buttercup, and the Powerpuff Girl logo. We got that. Show the nails. I didn't even show the nails, did I? Look at this shit with the damn Powerpuff Girl rainbow. Listen, I know some of y'all don't fuck with press-on nails, but I do because I change my nails way too much to go with my outfits. I'm just getting right into the looks. Famous then, famous now. No need to get into the guest judges and all of that until we get into the challenge and the final runway. So I'm gonna start with Kahana Montrese. I'm sorry, I'm gonna start with Alexis Michelle. Alexis Michelle, I love this golden age of Hollywood. I guess they made him give a reference because some people, they have references. And I was like, okay, if you want to call it that. But it just gave me old Hollywood glamour with that turban and the pantsuit. And it was this all white rhinestone suit. Great look. Something I wasn't expecting. I was really expecting Alexis Michelle to really do old Hollywood glamour the way she did for the promo look. But she gave me something different. She turned it. I thought she looked great. Her famous now, where she did the Kim Kardashian Balenciaga with everything blacked out.
I was into it. But with this being Dre, I kind of want to see your face. You know, you're not one of the well-known queens on this season, so that, and then I'm just going to tell you the truth. When she turned around and that ponytail was brown and not black, I was a little bit irritated. But at least I did get her references and for the challenge. Good and safe. Good and safe. Kahana Montrese. I will tell you, I did not like her old Fame look. It was old Hollywood in the way that it's like, okay, you got on a velvet dress and a Veronica Lake wave and love the foxtail shawl. Love that. But it wasn't giving me life for old Hollywood the way that I wanted it to. And if you remember what I said about her promo look, with her being showgirls and where's the body and who was wearing that to the Met Gala, and then what's the other Jenner? Not Kylie, but the other one. Jenner came to the Met Gala with her ass out. So I guess I was wrong. But I think that's just not in Kahana's wheelhouse to do like that old school glam, which is fine because what she's doing, I'm fucking into. Because her famous now, bitch, the Lil Nas X Versace pink cowboy, but as a gal, slay. Immediately knew the reference, immediately got it, didn't do an exact replica, no notes. She looked fantastic in that, and I ate it up with a spoon, and she ate up the runway. So here we are with that. I want to get into my girl Heidi in Closet, friend of the channel. And I loved her famous then look. I did not, till I saw it on Instagram, I did not get what was going on with her face. And I didn't get it till I seen the picture on Instagram. And I'm like, oh, okay, so she was like a porcelain doll. Like, okay, I get that. I loved the look. I don't get what a porcelain doll has to do with old Fang. I don't get it. I loved the look. She stepped that pussy up. Pussy was on fire. But I didn't get the look in the reference to what the challenge was. And then her famous now, again, I loved the look. Y'all know I'm Kawhi and I love a big ginormous bow. Love the look. Love the Bantu knot. Here we go. Love the Bantu knot wig. That looked so good. And it looked like that was her hair. And it looked so good. But you're saying Halle and Chloe Bailey. And that's why I'm saying, are y'all making them give a reference? Because to me, Heidi just had two dope looks. But I was not feeling either one of them for what the category was. But I loved the looks. I loved both of them. Mrs. Kasha Davis. I knew she was going to kill the old Hollywood. Didn't we all know she was going to kill old Hollywood? The headpiece was cool. I guess it was like a reference to Lucille Ball and the Ziegfeld Follies. It was cool. It was giving me old Hollywood. Like, I got it. But you might have should have wore that without the headpiece and wore what you wore for your Fame now, because that was Liza Minnelli. That was Liza Minnelli. That was not Kris Jenner. That was Liza Minnelli. Kris Jenner is just a little bit more fashion forward than that. I could see if it was just plain black, that being Kris Jenner at the crib. She talks so damn loud, and I know y'all probably can hear that. Anyway, but that's what I think about that. Nasha Lopez is another one that I was like, okay, I don't think your outfits are hitting the assignment. Like, I got the Coco Chanel reference, and it was giving me old fame. And I'll tell you why it was giving me old fame, because I was feeling like you was somebody in a Charlie Chaplin movie. But not Charlie Chaplin, though. So it's like, okay, Chanel was an upper brand. You would have to have been rich or famous to wear Chanel back then. And I get that. You are not giving me old fame and new fame. You are giving me old school and new school. And then I want to talk about the reference of her new school. Because Donatella Versace, with this take on the J-Lo dress, which I loved when she opened it up and it was that hot pink lining on the inside. Gorgeous. The beauty is here. Naysha, it looks good. But you're giving me a reference to Donatella Versace from the late 90s. It's 2023. I wanted to see somebody that was famous now. At least give me a reference in the last 5 years, not the last 30. Okay. Candy O. Because you know somebody got to kiss Rue's ass. I liked the look. I hated the hair. I'm sorry. I know people are out here living for that hair. I hated that stiff. The rollers just came out. Microwave ponytail. Freeze curl. Because it wasn't land right. Like, this one was just like, hey. Like, y'all don't know if y'all ain't from the era of the microwave ponytail. Like, and the freeze curl. Like, no, it's got to be. I'm sorry. I didn't like it. And then her new take on celebrity, to me, was very basic. Yeah, it's what celebrities wear now. It's a cute pink top, maxi skirt, sparkly, the fur, the blonde wig with the colors in it. It's very City Girls. It's giving me very that, but not City Girls, the rappers. It's just giving me very City Girls. Like, yeah, famous people wear that, but so did the bitch going to the club, too. It wasn't giving me enough. Darian Lake, girl, get in the basement. Get in the motherfucking basement, Darian Lake. Get in the basement. Get in the basement. You mean to tell me they said old school fame and you decided to dress up like a gypsy at a Renaissance ball? I don't get it. What is that famous for? Whose fame is that? I don't get it. Somebody else that also did. But, okay, so she did the new celebrity part. She did the new celebrity part. But of all the new celebrities you could do, and you are coming back to Drag Race after all these years, we love you. You know I will take a dip in the cool, refreshing waters of Darien Lake any day. You decided to do Billie Eilish, so you had on a t-shirt and some drawstring pants and an open-toe boot, which, by the way, when Billie Eilish wasn't wearing that type of stuff, she would never have had on a heel. Like, why did you think that was the idea? And you could have did Billie Eilish, because I'm going to tell you, I liked the glasses and the wig, and that was giving me Billie Eilish. But you couldn't have did something in a more drag way to be Billie Eilish? Like, if you were going to go there, give me a super oversized t-shirt that you made into a dress. Make it a lime green sequin t-shirt dress. It wasn't. Get in the basement. Get in the basement. That looked like that's what you threw on for a meet and greet before, because you about to have to get dressed for the show. It was bad. Monica Beverly Hills gives me Cleopatra, and it's cute. Now, I know Monica Beverly Hills go home this episode, spoiler alert. Because she's just not giving what the other girls are giving. She just wasn't. Now, this Cleopatra was gorgeous, but it was a cat suit and a cape. I mean, it was giving me high-end Halloween costume. I'm just being honest. And then that Kim Petras look was giving me Fashion Nova. I don't know much about Kim Petras. Did she wear something like this? But what I got was some boots and a leather crop top and a skirt. And it wasn't even like highly elevated. And it was giving me Pretty Girl, which Monica Beverly Hills is, beautiful woman. But you're not giving me drag, you're giving me Pretty Girl. I need more. James Mansfield 8. James Mansfield said, oh, I went home first. I bet it don't happen again. James Mansfield is eating and leaving no fucking crumbs for nobody. Listen here. When she did Old Fame. Now, I know some people are probably like, how is the mariachi? You think? I was thinking of like Three Amigos. I was thinking about like old black and white movies. But she did like this mariachi with this bolero, and she took it off, and it was like kind of burlesque. Like, it all worked so well. James Mansfield is not playing with you hoes at all. Then her famous now look, like I said, I feel like they made them give references because I did not get JoJo Siwa. However, I did get Fame Now. I got, these are outfits that celebrities are performing in now. They are hitting red carpets and stuff like this now. The Y2K aesthetic is very now. The harnesses and like BDSM elements mixed with the kawaii and the pastel colors and the like everything was right now. Because the Y2K is back. Everything is right now. I didn't expect to see James Mansfield in anything like this. The only thing is, I know you do your James Mansfield pinup girl little biscuit shoe. I would like to have seen a boot with this. Like a clear boot or iridescent boot or a lavender boot or a silver boot. I would like to have seen a boot with it because that's so now, or a booty. But James Mansfield ain't leaving no crumbs for you hoes. You understand? Okay, so next we have Jessica Wilde giving us Nefertiti. Again, elevated a bit more than Monica Beverly Hills's Cleopatra. Elevated a little bit more. But was I gagged and gooped? No. Very safe. But I loved her Famous Now, which I guess is a Bad Bunny reference where he was in drag. And this is the outfit he had on. And I didn't care. Because that is Fame Now. Give me all of the vinyl. Again, the shiny fabrics, the BDSM effect, the Y2K. It's all very now. The red over the knee patent leather boot with the whole suit being red patent leather with the glass. With the, because that is very now too, with the chic mullet. Like, it's now. It's Famous Now. Like, absolutely. And she killed that. We got to talk about Jimbo, though. Because how easy would it have been to just do Marilyn Monroe? But she gave me the drag clown and the draggery and the fuckery and foolery that I needed. With the dress being on wire, so it was permanently blown up like Marilyn's. And she gave me a shimmery white fabric, not just a white fabric, giving me all of the drag. Jimbo, yes, 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 and yes. Famous Now, I liked the cinnamon. I didn't love the outfit. I loved the thumbs up hair. I loved the like me, the follow down the back. I just didn't love the outfit. I thought that could have been done. The actual outfit could have been a little more clever with what she was going for. You can't fuck with that wig, though. I got a feeling you ain't gonna be able to fuck with none of her wigs. When we talk about part two, I'ma get into that. Cause for real, Jimbo was out here eating too. Listen, James Mansfield and Jimbo right now is, it ain't no room for the rest of y'all to eat. Goddamn. But that's that. Now, Lala Ree, famous then. Oh, it was so simple and clean. She said Diane Carroll, but it was definitely giving me that error. I don't know if it's the actual outfit that Diane Carroll wore, but it was giving me very that era. I think the hair was a little bit too modern. The hair was giving me a little bit more 90s than 40s, 50s, or 60s with the updo. But I don't mind it because this was just clean and beautiful. Which is a good thing because you're famous now. Now, I got to tell you, her Famous Now, the idea was on point. OnlyFans, get butt naked. Get butt naked for a buck. Made all the sense. But, them little cutout letters was not it, sis. They sell rhinestone letters at the craft store. She would have did that, and it would have been like the Britney Spears, kind of like some rhinestone elements to it, but definitely still that I'm naked. And then like that Ruly fans and subscribe would have been like a crystal clear rhinestone cut fucking letter. It would have been brilliant. The idea was there. The execution was poor. So, okay, we're having problems with the camera, so I'm recording on the phone. So I don't even know how this is going to work, but I want to give you a video. I kind of like the quality of this video better, but I have to see how I've recorded. I'll be back for part two tomorrow, and then we'll do episode two on Thursday, and then we right back on time, and I got you caught up. I will attempt to do geesh in one of these three damn videos. But as of right now, this is what it is. Thank you for watching. Thank you to my patrons. Thank you for the people that give me tips. Thank you for my birthday gifts. And keep it greasy. Deuces.